因為Glue Year 咧，其實咧雖然個名好似好 generic 咁啊，咁但係咧其實係一個好 specific 嘅 term 嚟嘅，咁樣咁啊 Glue Year， 咁咧其實咧好即係竟然好似一個好 generic 嘅名詞啦，原來係好 specific 嘅，咁就係、是。我哋講緊一堆嘢啦嚇，咁啊 otitis media 中耳炎咁樣，咁其實中耳炎咧 embed 咗好多嘢嘅喎 ，acute、chronic、suppurative、non-suppurative， 有啲就會變 cholestatoma， 但有啲又唔會嘅喎嚇。咁其實究竟係乜嘢嚟嘅咧嚇？咁呢度有一堆嘢啦，咁啊大部分全部都叫做中耳炎嘅啦嚇。咁咧就由最上邊左手邊開始啦，咁咧你見到咧嗰個耳膜咧。黃曬嘅嚇，咁咧就有啲 bulging 啦，好 congested 咁樣樣。咁啊，中間呢個咧紅嘅嚇，咁但係下邊又好似隱隱約約有條水咁，有啲 congestion 啦嚇。跟住右手邊呢個咧有啲 congestion， 有啲谷起出嚟，又有少少 fluid level。跟住下邊左下呢個咧就見到佢好似咧個耳膜好似比較睇落正常咗咁樣樣，但係咧留唔留意到咧前邊啦，即係可能係七八點嗰個位置咧有條坑嘅喎，咁啊露咗一條咧，我哋話嗰個叫做 annulus 啦，英文叫做 tympanic ring 啦，嚇中文咧就叫做鼓膜環啦出嚟咁樣樣，咁呢一個我哋話啲 retraction 喺度啦，咁到最尾咧呢一幅咧先至真正叫做 glue ear。就係話咧，有幾個 component 嘅，你見到個耳膜完整啦，嚇，咁嗰啲水咧係清嘅，嚇，帶啡黃色，同埋咧嗰個鼓膜環會露咗出嚟嘅，有一個 retraction 嘅情況喺度，咁樣，咁啊一堆都要中耳炎嘅，嚇，咁咧最後咧，其實咧有一個我哋嘅大師傅啦，叫 Morrison， 佢咧就喺1976年咧 define 咗我哋乜嘢叫做otitis media with effusion 或者 glue ear 啦，咁樣，佢個 definition 咧就話。中耳 middle ear cleft 咧有水嘅嚇，但係咧 absence of signs of acute infection， 耳膜一定唔可以穿 ，tympanic membrane is not perforated。咁係佢亦都喺嗰陣時已經留意到啦，佢係 sticky， 大部分情況都係 sticky 嘅 ，occasionally 咧係稀嘅 runny 咁樣。咁嗰啲嘢咧種出嚟咧一定係 sterile 嘅 ，contains glycoproteins 咁樣咧，就於是乎咧佢就 mucus like 啦。咁嗰陣時咧未有Western blot 啊，咁啊佢就淨係知道 glycoprotein 啊，咁一陣間佢講係咩 glycoprotein 咁樣。咁佢嗰陣時都已經留意到啦。所謂 acute 或者 chronic 嘅 otitis media 咧，其實佢嗰個分野咧係好 arbitrary 嘅啫嚇。咁咧究竟係兩個禮拜叫 chronic 啦，定係還是四個禮拜叫 chronic 咧？其實都係睇下個 onset 係點。咁啊，通常 chronic otitis media 咧就唔會有一個痛嘅感覺嘅。咁亦都係一個通常 insidious onset 咁樣，咁咧Morrison 佢呢本書咧就 rewrite 咗五次之後咧就即係佢就 pass away 咗啦咁樣，咁但係咧佢到而家咧佢都仲係我哋叫做 definition of otitis media effusion 嚇。咁咧跟住另外一個巨匠啦，我哋叫 Charles Wollstone， 咁咧 Charles Wollstone 今日仲喺度嘅喎，喺 Pittsburgh Children's Hospital。咁咧佢嗰個成世人啦，佢成個 research 嘅passion 啦，都係喺eustachian tube dysfunction 引致到嘅中耳問題啦。咁咧佢咧就將呢一樣嘢講得最清楚噶啦，就係話其實咧中耳炎咧由 acute 開始，咁咧佢可以自己變做 resolution 啦，但係亦都可以咧感染咗細菌變咗一個 suppuration 嘅。咁咧 suppuration 得好犀利咧，有機會穿埋耳膜啦。咁於是乎咧就 acute perforation 就會流埋耳窿啦。流咗耳窿之後咧，有幾個 resolution 有機會咧會 healing with a scar 啦，有機會變成一個 chronic perforation， 就係一個inactive 或者一個 active 嘅 perforation 啦，或者咧 persistent 咁樣有 discharge 變成一個 chronic suppurative otitis media 穿耳膜啦。嚇，咁咧喺佢呢一堆嘢入邊咧，得 persistent effusion 而且係 chronic 嘅話咧，先至係 glue ear。咁所以變咗其實 glue ear 咧，淨係呢個 term 咧，其實一個好 specific 嘅病，就係話。一個sequel of 一個 acute infection 之後咧，佢嗰個水流咗喺個耳仔度啦，佢又唔 drain， 但係亦都唔 suppurate， 咁咧於是乎佢就變成咗 otitis media with effusion。咁呢一個病咧可以 stagnant 嘅，可以咧一路保持住都係淨係有水喺個中耳度，但係咧亦都會有機會出一個 sequel 啦，或者係會變成 perforation 嘅。咁睇翻头先嗰啲相啦， 咁咧，你見到咧一個 acute suppurative otitis media 咧，你見到佢嗰個耳膜入邊咧嗰啲血管咧會好 congestion 嘅喎，嗰啲 radial artery 咯，我哋話一路生翻去嗰、那個malleus 個陰部嘅時候咧，就會有一條條嘅血絲啦。咁咧按個 backdrop 咧，嗰個tympanic membrane 咧會變咗好 cloudy 嘅嚇。咁你見到呢一個咧有啲 slight tension 嘅嚇，中間嗰個咧就係、是、一個。通常最初發的 acute viral otitis media 啦，咁佢個重點咧就係佢好紅啦，個 cone of light 咧就會 diffuse 咗嘅嚇，咁咧而且嗰、那個陰部上面嗰啲血管咧就會 congest 得好緊要啦，隱隱約約間唔中咧會見到少少effusion 嘅，咁而一個 acute suppurative pending rupture 嘅 otitis media 咧就喺右手邊啦，你見到佢個 tension 會大得好緊要啦。咁喺嗰個右上角啦，即係喺個 malleus 後邊嗰個位咧，好多時咧已經係因為個 information 咧塞住咗，我哋話個 middle ear 去個 master 個通道啦，咁咧嗰個位置有 granulation， 咁佢 pending rupture 啦，咁你都見到下邊嗰個位咧有啲 suppurative 嘅 exudate 喺下邊。咁當呢一樣嘢 resolve 咗咧，有下邊呢兩種情況出現啦。咁佢有機會resolve 咗咧，佢個中耳嘅壓力慢慢 restore 翻嚇。咁但係未 achieve 到 equilibrium 嘅時候咧，個耳膜咧會少少陷咗入去個中耳度，有一個 retraction 嘅情況。咁你見到個耳膜咧有翻一個正常嘅 cone of light 啦。咁咧佢好似比正常嗰個 transparency 高少少咁樣嘅。咁但系當你有 effusion 嘅時候咧，嗰、那個啡色嘅情況就會多好多啦。而且咧，佢嗰、那個因為個耳膜經過咗一個 inflammatory phase 之後咧，會有一個 mild atrophy。咁你見到佢比好似比正常再 transparent 啲嘅。咁你隱隱約約見到嗰、那個incustatedial junction 喺度嘅，咁樣就見到入邊附計嘅咁樣。
我想問你呢幾個咧？
上面那些就會很痛了，應該是不
是？是的，上面那些就很痛了，下面那些就很多時候是沒有 symptoms， 或者是一些 mild hearing loss， 或者 ear block sensation，
即是這每一張照片其實都會有一些某程度的 hearing loss， 應該
是的，是的，那這個就是 glue 了，是的，那是不是播到的條片？是的，那這個download下來的，為什麼叫 glue ear 就是這樣。咁咧，阿 Morrison 咧都留意到，其實咧佢好多時咧嗰啲 effusion fluid 咧係好黐住嗰條 suction 喉嘅，嚇、咁所以點解咧佢就改呢個叫做 glue ear 嘅名啦、就係因為佢嘅 stickiness 嚇、咁啊以前唔知道點解佢咁 sticky 啦，咁而家咧有 Western plot 啦，咁啊2010年啦，咁我哋解咗謎啦，咁樣就發現咧佢哋咧攞嗰啲中耳。咁啊，呢一班咁神心嘅人，梗係唔係 ENT 啦？咁啊，咁神心嘅係 respirologist 嚇。咁佢哋咧就係喺個 lab 嗰度咧 collect 咗呢啲小朋友嘅中耳嘅積水，然後咧就拎去咧做 Western plot， 就睇下咧究竟入邊咧嗰啲 protein 係咩成分嚟嘅咁樣。咁於是乎就發現係一隻叫 MUC5B 嘅 glycoprotein 啦，咁樣。咁咧 saliva 係佢嘅 positive。control 咁、其實佢係 saliva 好主要嘅 component 嚟嘅咁咧就MUC5B 咧，除咗佢係個名 of 個 glycoprotein， 亦都係個名 of 嗰條 gene 啦，咁樣。咁樣呢條基因咧，發現咧喺一啲佢正常呢一個 glycoprotein 咧就會喺口水啦。一啲 alveolar fluid 啦，同埋cervical mucus 嗰度分泌出嚟嘅。咁、如果佢呢條 gene upregulate 咗咧，亦都會有 implication 喺一啲adenocarcinoma 嗰度咁樣。咁所以變咗呢條 gene 仲有好多嘢可以研究落去啊，咁樣。咁但係呢一個就係話我哋話見得到原來咧嗰啲 mucus 入邊咧係有一種 special 嘅成分令到佢哋咁結嘅，咁而呢啲咁結嘅成分咧，亦都喺其他 pathology 入邊，例如話 otitis media effusion 啦、chronic rhinosinusitis 啦嗰度咧，亦都見得到呢啲 mucus 嗰、那個成分會增加咗嘅。咁、但係呢啲就暫時仲係 research base 咯，我哋就未有一個correlation 話呢一啲 mucus present 或者 absence 喺呢啲effusion 嗰度對個 treatment 嘅 implication 係點啦。咁 即例如 cystic fibrosis， 咁而家有 genetic therapy 啦，咁啊嗰啲成分 of 呢啲 mucus 有冇改變到咧？對於嗰、那個implication of 個 resolution of otitis media with effusion 有冇分別咧？咁暫時都仲係一個即係未有 conclusive 嘅階段咯嚇。咁、啊、有啲咩有 put 住咁啊？跟住呢份咁呢份咧就係、是、咧我哋話pathophysiology 啦咁樣樣。咁啊、這個review 咧其實就一個 open access journal 嚟嘅，不過我覺得佢寫得好夠清楚啦。咁啊，講翻咧，我哋而家咧 working on 個 pathophysiology， 亦都講緊我哋 implication of 我哋嘅 treatment 啦。嚇，咁我哋嘅觀眾今日多數都係 pediatrician 醫生，即係 physician 啦。咁所以變咗我比較多啊講嗰啲藥物多啲。嚇，咁傳統上啦，我哋話好耐之前已經知道啦 ，smoking 啊 ，cystic fibrosis 、ciliary dysfunction 會有 OME 啦。咁 adenoid 大 adenoid 入邊有 infection， 咁亦都會話有一個implication 引致到塞住咗 eustachian tube 啊 ，physically 或者影響咗佢嘅 function， 引致到有otitis media 或者一啲 cleft craniofacial 嘅小朋友，因為個 eustachian tube 嗰啲 muscle 嘅 attachment 嘅問題，有一個 eustachian tube dysfunction 亦都引致 OME 啦嚇。咁但係除咗一個物理上嘅阻塞，或者一個 cilia 嘅阻塞，即係 macro 或者 micro 嘅阻塞之外咧，原來而家咧我哋有亦都有一啲我哋話 cytokine theory 啦。咁咧佢哋就喺一個早啲嘅 pathophysiology 嗰度咧，就話 biofilm 啦、allergy 啦或者 reflux 咧，有機會 upregulate 咗嗰、那個respiratory mucosa 喺個 eustachian tube 嗰度，引致到佢有多咗 inflammation cytokine， 引致到多啲otitis media 啦。咁你見到啊，我寫埋個日期啊，即係佢哋第一次咧 ENT 嗰啲人幾時咧就 describe 呢樣嘢啦。咁、你見到我哋都係跟啲 physician 啊，啲physician 話而家我哋興研究包 film 啊，咁啊啲 ENT 又走去研究包 film 啊，咁樣嚇。咁啊就包 film 咧，約莫係五至六成左右啦，就話咧喺嗰啲otitis media 嗰啲 mucosa 嗰度咧，又話發現到有啲包 film。咁咧，但係呢啲包 film 有咩 significance 咧？暫時咧就又好似做唔到喎。跟住咧 allergy 啦，亦都係啦，就話喺嗰啲inflammation marker 嗰度咧，嗰啲 mucosa 嗰度發現某一啲 allergy marker 高咗啦，或者還是發現咗啲 allergen 啦。咁但係亦都又 translate 唔到出嚟嘅 ，mildly translate 到出嚟就係話原來噴啲類固醇落係有啲幫助嘅咁樣咁 reflux 就更加薄弱啦。咁咧就話，亦都喺嗰啲 mucosa 嗰度啦，發現一啲H. pylori 嚇。咁但係咧，啲 H. pylori 究竟係佢哋嗰啲significance 係點咧 ？treat 咗佢哋有冇辦法 resolve 到個 otitis media 咧？咁亦都係冇一個我哋話好 strong 嘅 evidence 喺度咁樣。咁但係只係話佢哋係一個 bystander 啊，定還是係佢一個 direct causative mechanism 咧？其實而家都仲未有一個結論咯。咁樣，咁咧，呢個 preference 啊，咁咧 preference 咧，其實又係個問題就係話咧，如果嗰啲中耳炎咧，好多時咧都去咗睇 GP 嚇，咁亦都好多睇 pediatrician 或者 A&E，甚至乎如果喺歐美國家咧，有陣時睇 pharmacist， 甚至係一個 visiting nurse， 咁所以變咗我哋其實對於嗰個 true preference 有幾多咧，我哋唔係太知嘅嚇。咁有啲 screening 嘅cohort 啦，就話咧。嗰啲細過一歲嘅小朋友就會有一半機會 at some point 有啲 effusion 喺度嚇。如果細過兩歲有機會六成添咁樣樣嚇。咁咧 general pediatric population 咧估估下嘅啫，咁啊幾個 percent 至一成左右 at any time 會有一個 effusion 喺度咁樣樣。咁但係如果佢係一個 special child 啦，咁佢T1 或者 cleft lip palate 嚟睇 chronic 有腹腔疹嘅，咁嗰啲嚟講咧都會有超過一半，甚至有成八成咧係會有。OME 喺度嘅嚇 ，sign and symptoms 咁小朋友咧同大人咧講嘢咧有啲唔同嘅喎嚇。咁小朋友咧，大人同細路講嘢咧，我哋叫 showering 啊嚇，因為咧啲聲咧係大人同小朋友咁樣向下落嘅嚇。咁所以變咗小朋友咧聽唔到嘢咧，佢就會好多時咧係用側頭嚟去 表達的、這樣，所以變成有時候小朋友經常頭側側、這是其中一個他們 hearing loss 的 symptoms、大人呢會懂得說我有 ear block sensation 或者這隻耳蒙了樣、但小朋友就比較少去 complain 這個問題，很多時候就留意到他、叫他不應、樣啊、所以變成有時候就會說有些好像、上學ADHD 嗰啲症狀啊，或者係 fail in school 啊咁樣樣咯，嚇咁咧2010年嗰陣時咧就都冇留意呢樣嘢嘅，咁呢個新 update 嘅 AAP guideline 咧就話其實有啲小朋友咧 clumsiness 嚇論盡啦，成日跌倒啦嚇，或者咧嗌頭暈啊。有陣時就同媽咪講我唔搭車我暈啊咁樣樣嚇，有陣時原來都是一個 otitis media with effusions 嘅 symptoms 嚟嘅。咁但係咧個問題係究竟有幾多個 percent 會咁樣 present 咧嚇？而又嗌頭暈嗰啲有幾多個 percent 係 otitis media 咧？咁呢啲咧其實我哋就係冇一個我哋話好 scientific 嘅 report 嘅 data 嘅咁樣樣。咁只係話呢一堆嘅 symptoms 有機會都係 point to 呢一樣嘢。咁 have to say 其實要 screen 一個 otitis media effusion 咧又唔係好困難嘅咁樣樣嚇。咁啊檢查啦嗱，咁啊如果你係 ENT 醫生，你有一支內窺鏡咧，一支就夠啦。咁咧又擠落個耳仔，擠落個鼻度，就即刻 make 到呢個 dilosis 啦。咁啊睇到一個 effusion， 咁樣然後咧就可以擠埋去睇埋個鼻有冇鼻塞啊，有冇 adenoid hypertrophy 啊咁樣樣。其實 pretty straightforward 嘅。咁但係我哋唔係啊嘛，即係我哋好多同事都係一個community pediatrician 啦，或者做其他科嘅。咁所以變咗咧，當你冇 endoscope 嘅時候咧，嗰啲 sign 會係點咧嚇？咁呢一張相你見到冇咁清嘅嚇，咁呢一個咧就係一個我哋用 otoscopy 影嘅otitis media effusion 啦。咁咧 otoscopy 嗰間燈咧橙黃色咧。咁咧，同埋咧，有時好暗啊，咁咧就好多時會見到呢一個我哋叫 blue drum 啊，咁樣就話咧，其實嗰啲折射嘅問題啦，咁咧就見到個耳膜唔同色嘅嚇。咁其實除咗白色之外，所有其他嘅顏色咧，你都可以當佢係有嘢噶啦嚇，咁樣。咁啊，跟住個小朋友咧，就通常睇落蠢啲嘅嚇 ，adenoid face 啦嚇，擘大口唞氣啦嚇，好似成日瞓唔夠精神咁樣啦嚇，眼耷耷咁樣嚇。跟住如果你擘大個口咧。就有機會見到一個moderate size 嘅 tonsils 啦，好多時 tonsils 同 adenoid size 係 correlate 嘅咁樣。咁間唔中咧，如果佢肯擘得個口夠大咧，你有機會見到啲 postnasal discharge 啦嚇。咁、如果你 very lucky 咧，有機會你就會見到上最後呢一個啦。我哋話見到一個common 嘅 congenital cause， 一個 bifid 或者一個我哋 submucous cord。cleft palate 啦，咁啊，如果你一個 ENT practice 咧，一個禮拜其實都有成一至兩個嘅，因為一個 submucosal cleft palate 咧，唔係真係咁 uncommon 啊。我諗可能 general population 入邊咧，有5% 咧都有機會係有一個submucous cleft palate 嚇。咁但係就唔多人 present with recurrent otitis media 嘅，咁 depends on 佢個 development 啦。咁有機會佢都仲有一啲function 喺嗰、那個。residual 嗰個adhesion 嗰度嘅，咁所以變咗佢哋就 variable presentation 啦，咁樣，咁啊 investigation， 咁其實就唔一定要做嘅，你如果見到有水，其實你已經可以 dilose 一個middle ear infusion 嘅啦，咁樣，咁但係咧就好 common， 我哋會 refer 個 patient 去做一個我哋要聽力測試啦，或者你做一個 tuning fork 啦，搏下佢睇下啊，你咪大聲啲啊 ，bone conduction 大聲過 air conduction 啦，咁樣，咁如果你去 refer 佢去做一個tympanogram 啦，咁呢一個就係一個 typical 嘅 tympanogram 啦，咁樣 depends on 嗰啲積水嘅其實，咁咧就variable a grade of hearing loss 啊，通常由15至40 dB 都可以嚇。廣東話，我而家呢個咁樣嘅中年女人廣東話咧，其實都55 dB。咁咧就40至50 dB 咧，其實咧係一個好 arbitrary 嘅聽力問題。咁我哋留意到咧，廣東人咧好少咧會 complain about hearing loss，even 佢哋有 effusion。咁主要都係因為我哋講嘢真係大聲啲嘅，係啊嚇。咁英文啦嚇，第五啊 fifth。巴士 bus 或者係king 咁咧呢啲我哋話啲英文嘅輕音啊 k 啊 f 啊 th 啊咁樣樣，咁咧頭先我個發音咧約莫係30 dB 左右 咁所以變咗咧，其實都 depends on 你個mother tongue 係乜嘢。咁好多時，如果佢真係用英文做 mother tongue 咧，佢對於 hearing loss 嗰個忍受嘅 threshold 咧會低好多嘅。咁所以變咗咧，其實歐美咧，Gromit 咧係一個 ultra common 嘅手術，係 very very common。但係相對起中國人啦，即係我哋無論自己朋友啊，或者自己 patient 嘅經驗咧，都發現咧，好多時佢就算有 effusion 咧，佢哋都唔 complain about hearing loss。有陣時父母亦都唔 complain about hearing loss。咁呢個就係即係我哋話 ENT 嘅特別嘅地方啦，即係我哋個 linguistic 或者我哋個 culture 咧，對我哋個 management 咧，點解會有唔同啦？咁咧就好多時我哋話唔醫或者醫好少個 conductive hearing loss 係呢個原因啦，咁樣。咁咧就除咗嗰個 conductive hearing loss 之外咧，我哋另外一樣嘢會常做嘅咧，就一個叫 tympanometry 啦嚇。咁 tympanometry 係咩咧？一句解釋咧就係話，如果我哋有一個氣球，即係有個膜，然後我哋篤佢入邊係空氣嘅話，同我哋有一個膜入邊嗰個啫喱，我哋篤佢嘅話咧，嗰個感覺咧會好唔同嘅，嗰個回彈力個感覺嚇。Basically 係一樣咁嘅嘢啦嚇。咁咧。佢喺個耳膜嗰度，後邊係空氣啊，定係水啊？我哋咧就用一個 tympanometry 去度。咁佢個原理就係話，我戴一粒耳塞，嗰、那個耳塞咧有一個空氣喺度先，將耳仔個氣壓咧定咗喺某一個 threshold 嗰度，然後我哋就播一個聲音俾佢聽，噗一聲。咁呢個噗一聲咧，就引致個耳膜有一個喐動喺度啦。咁呢個喐動嘅時候就會產生一啲 waveform， 咁我哋喺個 recorder 嗰度 measure 翻個 waveform 就得到出唔同嘅答案啦嚇。咁正常嚟講，如果佢入邊係空氣嘅，咁我篤落去個耳膜好輕巧咁樣咧，就彈翻個空氣翻過嚟，咁於是乎就會成為一個我哋叫 pitted 嘅 team 啦。咁但係如果當佢係一個積水嘅時候咧，嗰、那個 team 咧就會變咗平咗啦咁樣，因為咧我哋篤落去。嗰、那個震動嘅力咧，有部分就俾入邊啲啫喱射咗，於是乎彈翻出嚟嗰啲空氣咧就會平咗啦。咁所以簡單嚟講，一個 team 如果佢係平咗，或者佢一個冇 peak 嘅 team 咧，咁就代表佢入邊咧有積水喺度啦。嚇，咁啊而家如果你哋 refer 佢去一個 private 嘅一個 audiology lab， 可能500至700元左右啦。咁佢就會幫你做一個tympanometry 同埋一個 threshold assessment， 其實都係一個好 accessible 嘅一個 investigation 嚟。
我記得呢個係 membership 咧，嗰啲 written test 會搞會考嘅，咁啊大家 train 啲就都唔好唔知啦呢樣嘢啊。
係啊，咁啊好啦，咁如果你真係要再 investigate， 咁啊又冇 endoscope 嘅情況係點咧？所有地方都有啊 ，A&E 好多時 GP 都 assess 到嘅，就係、一個 natural skull X-ray 啦，咁樣。咁呢個 X-ray 咧，見到其實都幾容易睇到嘅嚇。咁咧就係個 adenoid 嗰個位置啦。咁咧就你見到揸咗條頸嘅，咁咧就係有一個凹咗落去嘅位置。咁嗰個位置咧就係、嗰個 adenoid 引致到嗰個 nasopharyngeal narrowing 啦。如果你要好科學化咁去做呢件事咧，你就可以喺嗰度咧去做一個 measurement of 個 point 嘅。咁嗰條 N 線咧 ，A 線就簡單咧 ，adenoid 線啊嘛，就係嗰個 adenoid 最肥嗰個位置啦。嚇，咁如果嗰條 N 線咧，就係咧將嗰個 basal sphenoid 墮落去咧嗰個 posterior edge of 嗰個 palate 嚇，最後一隻牙上顎最後一隻牙後邊嗰個位咁樣，就墮一墮嗰度嗰個比例啦嚇。咁啊，同所有嘅兒科嘢一樣啦，有一個standard deviation 嘅，有條 curve 咁樣，咁咧就會得出一個答案，就係一個咩嘅比例咧，就叫做大好多啦咁樣。咁但係你見到啦，條 mean 咧其實都係5×5/6啦，0.5×0.6嚇，最大係0.5×0.6。咁所以變咗咧，如果一個 AN ratio 即係話佢超過一半塞咧，其實佢好大機會都係塞噶啦。咁樣咁就可以即係measure 下。咁呢個 AN ratio 咧，其實喺呢啲文獻嗰度啦，都有 validate 到嘅。咁佢哋咧都 validate 咗 tutorially with 嗰個 endoscope 咧，嗰個 positive correlation 係超過90%嘅。咁所以變咗咧，亦都係一個其中一個叫做比較簡單嘅 measure 去 arrive 到個 diagnosis 啊。咁樣係啦。咁啊，跟住講下醫唔醫病啦嚇。咁咧。首先問點解要醫先嚇？咁啊，如頭先講啦，即係15至40 dB 嘅 hearing loss， 中國人咧好多時覺得唔使醫嘅嚇。咁如果你話個細路因為咁樣成日咧giddy 嚇，成日側頭， 或者咧佢上堂唔專心嘅，咁有陣時呢一個 hearing loss 係一個我哋話要 treat 嘅原因啦嚇。咁但係有陣時就算佢 hearing loss 冇咁多，或者佢冇乜其他 symptoms 咧，我哋 ENT 人咧都會覺得要 treat 嘅。咁點解咧？就係頭呢一個圖畫啦嚇。咁你見到咧呢兩隻耳仔咧都係有一個 otitis media with effusion 嘅嚇。咁但係嗰個 A 圖啦，左邊嗰個咧，其實係一個比較長時間嘅 effusion。咁你留意到咧，佢嗰個上邊啦1.至到三點嗰個位置啦，佢比起對面嚇，你會發現咧嗰度嗰個 blood capillaries 咧好似弱咗咁樣樣嘅嚇，咁樣樣。咁咧就係話咧，其實咧我哋嗰、那個tympanic ring 嘅 blood supply 咧係喺嗰個 anterior tympanic artery 嗰度嚟。咁咧當佢入邊 middle ear 有一個 chronic 嘅negative pressure force 嘅時候咧，就好似咧你有啲嘢夾硬掹住佢。咁於是乎個 blood flow 喺一個 arterial 甚至一個 capillary 嘅 blood flow against 一個 negative pressure， 咁咧短時間冇問題嘅，但如果長時間咧，佢就會引致嗰度嗰啲骨咧有 remodeling， 唔夠嘢食嚇。咁於是乎咧，你見到 A 圖咧開始咧，佢上邊嗰個位置咧嚇11.個位置嚇，咁你見到佢有一個我哋話 attic remodeling 開始有一個 retraction 喺度啦嚇，咁咧。有些人咧，佢就會一路 recheck 落去啦，咁樣樣。咁佢好似左邊個圖畫咁啦，佢 recheck 落去咧，佢上面個 attic 嗰啲骨咧有 remodeling 啦，嚇。咁咧 remodeling 到一個點咧，個耳膜咧自己頂唔順啦，我自己穿咗佢啦。咁我自己穿咗佢耳盔翻個 pressure 佢啦，咁樣樣。咁呢個 patient 咧，佢就會 suffer 咗一個即係erosion of 嗰個 attic wall 啦。咁同埋咧，佢個 perforation 咧就會 expose 咗佢 middle ear 出嚟啦。咁呢個 perforation 咧係一個 uncontrolled 嘅 perforation 啦。佢揀咗喺嗰啲耳骨上邊咧有個 perforation。咁如果佢有一個 infection 嘅時候咧，佢嗰個 middle ear， especially 嗰啲ossicles 咧，佢就 directly expose 去到個 infection 嗰度啦。咁於是乎咧就 predispose 個 patient 咧一個我哋話 chronic ear 嘅問題啦。咁佢呢一世人咧，佢都要好小心。如果佢入咗水，或者佢游水又好，潛水又好，玩又好，佢有啲水入咗去嗰個中耳嗰度咧，佢個耳嗰啲 ossicles 就會有一個 infection risk 喺度啦，咁樣樣嚇。咁有啲人嗰、那個耳仔咧，個耳膜嗰個強韌度係高啲嘅，佢冇一個 atrophy 得咁犀利嘅，咁於是乎個耳膜就唔穿啦。咁但係咧，嗰啲骨就頂唔順啦，咁就會變成咗右邊嗰種 condition 啦。佢個 attic 咧就會變咗一個 retraction 嘅 pocket 喺度。咁而嗰個位置咧就會積咗一啲耳道嘅皮膚啊，我哋話一啲 keratinizing material、keratinizing squamous epithelium， 於是乎就引致到我哋所講嘅 cholesteatoma 咁樣。咁所以點解我哋覺得要醫咧，就係話佢一個 middle ear 嘅 pressure 嘅問題。咁所以變咗，就算佢冇 hearing loss。如果個 patient with 一個 long time 都冇一個 resolution 喺度嘅話咧，我哋都會 counsel 個 patient for 一啲treatment 去醫翻呢一個中耳積水或者中耳 negative pressure 嘅問題，去引致到可 prevent 呢啲 sequela。咁 have to say 啦，由佢中耳炎至到佢發展到呢個情況咧，係講2年嚟計嘅。咁所以變咗有陣時你都要俾到個 insight 個 patient， 呢啲嘢未必即刻發生，但係咧 treat 唔 treat 咧都可以有時間去 counsel 佢嘅咁樣。咁但係有啲嘢冇得 counsel 嘅，就是、growth。咁咧呢一張圖啊影乜嘢咧？就係話咧呢一張普通嘅 CT brain 嚟嘅咋嚇。咁但係咧你見得到咧，佢右手邊啦，呢張圖嘅右手邊啦，嗰、那個 mastoid bone 咧，你見到冇乜 aeration 嘅。我哋話叫 sclerotic mastoid 嚇，咁我哋相信咧一個 chronic 嘅otitis media 喺一個 pediatric 嘅 case 嗰度，佢咧就會引致到嗰個 middle ear 嗰個ventilation 咧 jeopardize 嚇。咁當你 middle ear 都 ventilate 唔到啦，咁你後邊嗰個 mastoid 同個 antrum 就更加冇 ventilation 啦。咁於是乎咧喺一個發育嘅情況之下咧，佢嗰度咧就會變咗一個 low priority of growth。咁於是乎佢嗰個 mastoid air cell 嘅 system 咧就會細咗咁樣嚇。咁一個細嘅mastoid air cell， 佢喺通常嗰個 mastoid air cell 成個development 嘅 frame 咧就係、是、約莫係0至4歲。咁當頭先講啦 ，otitis media 大部分都1至2歲喎，而你0至4歲嘅時候，亦都係同時間你個 mastoid 發育。咁於是乎你個 mastoid 個 aeration 咧冇發育到。咁、即係等於咧冇咗一個 buffering 喺度， 同lung一樣嘅啫。你一兩成咧係冇問題嘅嚇，即係但係咧，如果你冇曬成個 buffering 咧，你成世人都會好 high risk， 咁你就會有一個 risk of 佢個中耳 ，once 佢中耳有一個negative pressure， 佢就好容易穿耳膜或者再有 otitis media，因為佢嗰個 master 入邊嗰冇一啲 ASL 去幫佢 equalize 個 pressure。所以變成 pediatric 呢，如果要 treat 一個 otitis media with effusion 呢，其實要更加 aggressive， 因為呢 once the master growth is complete， 咁呢你就 bear 個 patient with a lifelong risk of a very susceptible ear。 咁去返醫病啦，咁頭先講啦，我會講多啲點樣用藥嚟醫病嘅，咁樣咁睇返個 pathophysiology，咁啊有好明顯啦，有幾種藥咧有機會會有用啦。咁啊第一種啊講係 antibiotics 啦。咁 antibiotics 應該可以用嚟打包菌啊，同埋咧應該咧可以攞嚟咧就打 acute infection 啦咁樣嚇。咁咧我哋而家咧個 guideline 咧就係話，如果佢一個 uncomplicated 嘅 acute viral infection 咧，我哋就唔 suppose 要俾 antibiotics 嘅 ，only when it has sign of suppuration， sepsis 或者嗰啲 special child 咁樣。咁但如果 antibiotic 喺一個冇咗 suppuration 嘅情況之下，淨係用嚟醫 effusion 又得唔得嘅咧？咁樣咁咧，我哋一六年係啦，咁一六年咧，我哋咧最後咧就有人就做咗一個 Cochrane review 啦，咁樣咁呢度入邊咧，其實最後咧得16個 study 咧係 include 咗嘅啫。咁雖然16個 study 約莫有3000個病人啦，但如果你話以一個咁 common 嚟病嚟講咧，其實咧都係真係好細型啊嘅 Cochrane review。咁樣，咁咧佢就發現咧，竟然咧嗰啲 data 咧係好 heterogeneous 嘅 ，heterogeneous。咁咧我哋嗰啲 data 咧好多咧都冇 measure 一啲audiometric 啊，或者係一啲tympanometry 嘅 data 去 ratify 我哋嗰啲 outcome measure 咁樣。咁最後咧呢一份Cochrane review 嘅答案咧就係話 antibiotics 咧其實個 risk 同個 benefit 咧都仲係好 arbitrary。咁咧就佢會見到咧 antibiotics 有 slight improvement in the duration of the otitis media， 佢會可能將你個 otitis media 個 resolution time 縮短咗少少嚇咁樣。咁但係咧 antibiotics script 咧同時咧亦都有好多 side effects about diarrhea 啊 rash 啊咁樣嚇。咁同埋你見到啲研究咧俾嘅藥咧都好多唔同嘅類型啦。咁啊多數都有 amoxicillin 嘅或者係albuterol 嗰個 group 啦咁樣。但係俾嘅日子咧，你見到大部分研究咧會俾一個即係兩個禮拜到嘅 course 啦。但係亦都有人咧俾一啲 month long courses 嘅。咁啊，俾半年嘅 antibiotics 去睇下可唔可以 avoid 咗一個 growman 咁樣嚇。咁所以變咗咧，佢個結論就係話they don't recommend antibiotics 去 treat otitis media with effusion， only in a very selected 嘅 case 啦。咁樣咁啊，亦都反映咗我哋 specialty 嘅問題啦。我哋嗰啲因為冇一個 consensual 嘅outcome measure 啦，咁於是乎我哋就有啲 inconsistent 嘅 reporting 嘅問題。咁啊，近幾年咧，因為呢個 Mucin 嘅問題啦，咁啊話Mucin 可以有 macrolide 一個 empty inflammatory 嘅 effect， 令到啲 Mucin 稀啲咁樣，咁所以變咗咧，近呢幾年咧，亦都有啲 report 咧就話一啲 long term low dose 嘅 macrolide may be infective 咁樣，咁所以你見有啲研究咧又會有 clarithromycin 或者 erythromycin 係去幫助嗰個potency of 個 antibiotics。咁啊，第二類啦，就係話，咦？咁我哋醫 allergy 又得唔得咧？咁樣樣，咁於是乎就用 nasal steroid 或者 oral steroid。咁我諗大部分咧都好少人會用一個 systemic oral steroid 嚟去醫一個 otitis media with effusion 嘅。咁啊，主要嘅 discussion 咧就係 nasal steroid 啦。咁 nasal steroid 除咗醫 allergy 之外，佢亦都有一個 effect on， 因為佢 allergy 減少。Adenoid 嗰個 lymphoid overgrowth 咧，亦都冇咁 active 咧 ，maybe have effect on adenoid as well。同埋咧，有啲人亦都相信啦，嗰啲nasal steroid 有少少幫助嗰個 cilia function 啦。嚇，咁呢一張咧就係中山嘅紙嚟嘅，咁佢就直出喺一個 open access 嗰度嘅。不過咧，佢就好勤力嚇，咁咧佢咧就幫300多個病人咧去咧。噴類固醇咁咧就然後咧就睇下咧佢哋咧嗰個 adenoid 咧係咪真係可以減少 infection？ 咁咧佢咁神心咧，你見佢咧就零 week two weeks 14-26， 咁你見到咧佢咧就可以咧 demonstrate 到一個咧，我哋話 gradual decline of the adenoid。你睇下嗰啲 mucus 咧，本來 A 相咧，你見到佢遮住曬個 eustachian tube 嘅嚇，咁咧你見到 B 相咧，開始咧個 eustachian tube 出翻嚟啦嚇，咁咧由 C 相咧，你見到個 eustachian tube 出翻嚟啦，冇咗咁多 mucus 啦，去到 D 相咧，甚至變好似一個正常嘅 mucosa 咁樣，咁所以一個 long term nasal steroid spray 咧 is also effective， at least 喺 decrease 嘅 adenoid irritation 同個 size 嗰度咯，咁樣。咁咧，佢用嘅藥咧就 budesonide， 即係 rinocort 啦，咁樣。咁另外兩種其他藥嘅 antihistamine 或者 nasal congestion 咧，我哋咧就有啲細型啲嘅研究咧就 demonstrate 唔到有咩作用嘅。咁於是乎咧，就有人就做啲長型啲嘅研究啦。咁就話啊，如果我噴 nasal spray 一段長嘅時間，有冇幫助咧令到個 resolution of 個 otitis media with effusion 咧咁樣？咁呢張咧 Skedding 係我哋又係 ENT 嘅，咁咧佢係 from UCL 嘅。咁但係唔知點解呢一份 paper 咧佢出咗咧係冇 DOI 嘅咁樣。咁但係咧佢好 diligent 嘅，咁亦都係跟進咗超過三年啦。就係話咧，究竟用 nasal spray 可唔可以令到個 resolution 同埋嗰個一個 sustained effect in terms of 嗰、那個resolution of otitis media 咧咁樣。咁佢呢個研究就發現咧，nasal steroid 咧係好有效嘅。用一個long course 嘅 nasal steroid 啦，講緊亦都係六個月啦，可以咧將嗰、那個otitis media 可以減到差唔多一半嘅。超過一半的，你見藍色那條線就是那個 steroid 啦，咁樣黑色那條線就是control， 藍色那條線就是噴類固醇咁樣。咁你見到本身個病咧，佢自己都會有 resolution 嘅。咁用 placebo 咧，佢都有 25% 嘅病人咧，其實喺20日之後，佢都有一個 resolution 喺度。咁但係如果你用咗 steroid 咧，就會將佢撳到去變咗可能係六成都可以有 resolution 咯，咁樣嚇。咁另外紅色同綠色嗰兩條線係咩嚟嘅咧？就係另外一個 device 嚇。咁我哋相信咧，個 middle ear 有 negative pressure 啊嘛。咁如果我哋俾翻啲 positive pressure from 個 eustachian tube side。得唔得咧？咁樣咁啊，所以於是乎佢另外一樣嘢咧就 compare 一個叫 Otovan 啦，咁樣最巧妙嘅事咧就係話，原來咧佢呢個研究最大嘅 flaw 咧，或者點解會冇咁乜人引用咧，就係話點解 steroid 加多一樣嘢，加埋嗰個 positive pressure device， 反而個 effect 冇淨係 steroid 咁有效嘅咧，咁樣。咁但係你見到咧個 positive pressure device 啦，即係紅即係綠色嗰條線啦。itself 咧都好有效嘅咁樣，咁所以變咗咧呢一、這個咧就係呢一個研究可能冇 widely publish 嘅主要原因啦，就係話我有啲嘢佢自己都 explain 唔到啊咁樣嚇，咁但係咧呢一、這個就帶出咗另外一種 treatment method 啦，即係唔用 pharmaceutical， 唔用類固醇，唔想用 long term steroid 嘅第三種 treatment 啦，就係話我哋泵翻啲氣入去嘅 middle ear 又得唔得咧？咁樣咁傳統上就教佢哋做 valsalva 啦，咁樣咁當點樣教一個 pediatric， 尤其是一歲兩歲兩歲三歲嗰啲做 valsalva 咧？咁樣咁於是乎咧就有一個咁嘅 device 叫 Otovan， 攞個鼻吹波嚇。咁其實佢有兩個 component 啦，一個膠波同埋一粒膠粒咁樣，跟住咧嗌個小朋友撳住一邊鼻。就攞嗰個鼻咧嚟試下吹波，咁於是乎咧就 generate 一個 positive pressure from 個 eustachian tube nasal side 去個 middle ear 嗰度谷嗰只耳仔啦，咁樣嚇。咁啊呢個就係佢個 instruction of use 嚇，咁樣就解個病人撳住個鼻吹氣。咁咧吹嘅時候咧，你可以 visualize 到個 direction 係啱啦，因為吹嘅時候咧，佢向個波嗰度，亦都同時咧吹埋去個中耳嗰度。咁樣教佢嘅方法就話啊，你最好一日吹三次啦，咁樣。如果唔得閒吹三次，就吹兩次啦，咁樣。最緊要即係 persistent 啦，嚇。咁啊，最佢個 treatment advice 就係 2-3 weeks 咁樣。咁啊，呢個嘢就發現，如果你做研究嘅情況咧，佢哋就會嘅去做4個禮拜。咁樣佢就可以咧 improve 個 middle ear pressure。 咁咧就通常咧個 patient 咧都可以 report 到一個 symptomatic relief 嘅咁樣，但係咧佢嗰個audiological 或者 tympanometry 嗰個 significance 咧就暫時佢又 demonstrate 唔到嘅咁樣。不過咧佢嗰啲研究咧出嚟咧又都話，第一 low cost， 第二咧亦都冇乜 side effect，nothing they can think of， 即係我收法下咁樣。咁所以最後咧佢就攞到 license 嘅。咁而家就都好 widely available 噶啦。如果你加拿大啊、美國啊、英國嗰啲 pharmacist 咧，好多時咧都唔需要醫生 prescription 就可以買得到啦。咁樣，咁佢哋主要咧佢 license 就係 for otitis media 啦、glaucoma 啦。咁咧就有啲咧就叫搭飛機耳仔啦、pressure ear symptoms 啦，同埋有啲 patient 咧佢係俾人 demonstrate 到佢有一個 negative ear pressure retraction problem。咁咧佢哋都會話你可以用呢個 Otovan 去試下幫助你咁樣。有啲研究都好得意噶，佢就話啊，咁我唔用佢嗰個波得唔得咧？自己粒個 party balloon 落去又得唔得咧？咁樣咁佢哋就 demonstrate 到咧，其實個 effect 係好 similar 嘅咁樣。咁但係呢啲 medical device 咧，咁咧我哋就一般唔會咁建議嘅。如果你買咧，你就買佢嗰個波啦咁樣。Which is 冇嚇，咁我嗌佢哋咧就上 Amazon 買嘅。係啦，咁又係啦，因為 low cost 同埋 minimal side effect， 咁所以變咗咧上 Amazon 買都應該唔係犯法嘅咁樣。咁咧就150蚊港紙一套啦嚇。咁一套嘅意思咧就有個膠盒，有粒膠，同埋有五個波度嚇咁樣。咁波有 size 嘅，有大人啦、中童同埋小童嘅咁樣。
做幾多次啊？
通常做一日做三次，
一日
做一個月咁樣咯嚇咁樣。咁啊，好啦，咁啊 ，at the end 我都系一个 surgeon 嚟嘅，咁我都会讲下我哋啲 surgery 嘅，咁但系我 I keep it brief 咁样，咁啊，去到呢个 point 药唔得，做埋呢、這个吹波唔得啦，咁啊手术又得唔得咧？咁样，咁手术梗系得啦，咁啊你戴个 glomer 落去，咁啊梗系可以。Van 條嚟翻兩邊耳仔啦，通咗佢，咁兩邊嗰個 pressure equalize， this fluid drain 咗出嚟啦，咁啊即刻醫好啦。咁所以變咗咧，我哋成為咗打壓嘅對象，因為咧 circumcision 咧都係得一半人要做，但係 glomer 咧係可以咧有機會全部人口都要做嘅。咁所以變咗喺歐美咧，美國嗰啲保險公司啦，同埋咧NHS 其實都俾好大壓力，我哋嗰啲學會咧。咁咧就去即係點樣可以唔需要做咁多呢個手術咁樣？咁尤其是呢個病有部分人會自己 self resolution 噶嘛，咁樣。咁所以變咗咧，呢一個 argument 咧喺我做啱啱做醫生嗰陣時咧，簡直係最 heat 嘅事嚟嘅。咁咧就嗰年咧就係咧 Nice Guy 咧，英國嗰個 Nice Guy 同埋 AAP 咧隔相隔一年之間咧就出咗兩份 Guy 都係話我哋覺得要兩邊40 dB 我哋先至可以做高密。咁樣，如果唔係保險唔會賠俾你 ，lice 亦都唔建議咁樣。咁跟住咧，我哋個工會咧好大反應啊！咁樣有個叫 ENT UK 啦，都係為咗呢件事先成立嘅。咁咧就啲 ENT 醫生成立嘅一個工會啦。咁啊即刻做啲研究啦，就話其實40 dB 會唔會真係多得滯啊？即係你40 dB 影唔影響啊？咁樣。咁於是乎咧，佢哋當時咧就即刻好快咁樣又做一堆研究咧，就係究竟幾多 dB 咧先至影響到個學生讀書咧？咁樣。咁最後嘅結論就係16 dB。就話咧，16 dB 或者以上咧，個小朋友翻學咧就會爭啲噶咁樣。咁咧就喺翻學嘅時候咧，如果老師對住你咧，16 dB 就冇影響嘅。但係實在學校係唔係老師對住你噶嘛？咁你一班細路噶嘛？咁所以變咗一坐得遠咗咧，16 dB 就好大影響啦。咁樣，咁於是乎咧就反抗呢個guideline啦。咁樣，咁最後咧就即係經過好多協商之後咧，最後咧其實咧。AAP 嗰份街拉第二份咧，講緊係應該2016年冇記錯，佢就軟化咗嘅嚇。咁佢就將咧即係嗰個threshold 嘅街拉係冇變嘅。咁但係佢就話，如果佢喺即係大過20至40之間咧，咁咧就有一個 discussion 喺度啦。咁例如話個 patient 有冇成日跌倒啊，有冇嗌頭暈啊，又或者有冇俾老師投訴咧，都加埋落去個街拉嗰度，成為咗咧可唔可以做 GOMED 嘅理據啦咁樣。咁所以變咗。究竟等幾耐？等三個月，等嗰25% 嘅人 resolution 啊嘛，咁啊等唔等嗰三個月咧？等做 單邊做唔做得先嚇，咁同埋咧嗰個 threshold 係幾多先咁樣樣，咁其實咧就係、是、都仲有好多 argument 嘅，咁呢啲 argument 亦都 continuous 嘅咁樣樣，咁所以變咗呢個世界亦都唔再係咁簡單啦，即係除咗即係scientific 嘅嘢之外咧，亦都有一啲 social 嘅 implication 啦，同埋 political 係啦。political 同 financial 嘅 implication 喺度，咁所以變咗咧，亦都唔係一件咁簡單嘅事啦。嚇，咁啊擺咩猴仔啦？嚇，咁樣樣，咁啊呢啲我哋嘅傳統嘅膠粒型嘅猴仔啦，有啲擺啲 silicon 嘅猴仔啦，有啲 T shape 嘅猴仔咧，有冇分別喺度啊？咁樣樣，咁亦都係有啲好多嘅唔同嘅 argument 喺度啦，咁樣樣嚇。咁啊幾時做埋個 adenoid 咧？咁樣樣，哇你！高密已經夠多噶啦，仲要加多個 adenoid 落去，咁啊更加多啊！咁所以變咗咧，有啲咧就話啊應該做兩次先嚇，咁有啲就話唔係應該一次咁樣樣，亦都有啲話可以唔做就早唔好做啦咁樣樣，咁所以變咗咧，其實咧而家例如我哋香港咁咧，就通常去到第二次，即係第一次就咁擺咗高密先，第二次我哋先做埋 adenoid decrement 咁樣樣。咁但係呢一樣嘢咧，亦都係喺中國大陸就未必係一樣啦。咁好多時佢哋咧。過咗條河咧，佢哋就好多時第一次佢哋就做埋個 adenoid 嘅啦，嚇咁樣。咁亦都係啦。如果你喺父母嘅角度咧 ，immediate resolution of the nasal obstruction and the hearing。咁啊，今朝入去仲係一個蠢細路，出嚟晏晝已經醒目曬。咁所以變咗咧，佢哋唔同嘅 practice 咧，對於一啲個 surgery 嗰、那個requirement 咧，會有好大嘅即係唔同嘅 influence 啊，咁講嚇。咁啊 ，adenoidectomy 啦，咁 adenoidectomy 咧 used to be a very simple surgery， 咁咧就話擘大個口咯，把刀刮出嚟咁樣樣嚇，咁但係呢一個手術咧，擘大個口刮出嚟呢下咧，有1% 嘅 bleeding risk 啊，咁所以變咗而家我哋嘅就不停咁去 improve 我哋嗰個surgical 嗰個 safety 啦嚇咁樣樣，咁咧我哋而家我哋個 standard 咧會已經係用一個 endoscopic 嘅 adenoidectomy 啦，咁喺個口或者喺個鼻度啦嚇，攞一個直或者一個角度嘅內窺鏡。就望上去個 adenoid 嗰度去拎走佢啦，咁可以用一個我哋叫 suction monopolar diaphragm 啦，一個 coblation device 或者一個 micro debrider device， 咁啊個 safety 係增加咗嘅，減少咗流血嚇，減少咗inevitable injury to 嗰、那個aberrant carotid 或者係一個 palate 或者一個 eustachian tube 嘅影響，但係唔好處咧，亦都係啦。亦都幾 significant 咁增加咗手術嘅 cost 嘅嚇咁樣樣嚇，咁所以變咗個 complication profile 係 more safe， 但係 we pay much more for this safety as well 咁樣。咁啊 coblation 而家講緊係2000多一支度咯 ，suction monopolar 800度嚇 ，micro debrider device 1000多度咯咁樣樣。咁呢啲全部都 add up to the cost of the surgery。咁所以點解頭先講咯，第幾次先至做 adenoidectomy 咧，去增加呢一個個 cost 咧咁樣，亦都係一個好多 argument going on 嘅地方。咁咧新嘢，咁咧就係話咧要 eustachian tuberoplasty。咁樣，咁咧就其實都係源於 Pittsburgh 嘅。咁咧就 Bluestone 嘅有個繼任人叫 Dennis Poe 啦。咁咧佢咧個畢生嘅研究咧就係話，既然個 eustachian tube 係咁 key point to 呢一個otitis media， 亦都咁影響個發育，究竟我哋揾嘢通一通佢又得唔得咧？咁樣，咁佢嘅原理咧就係話喺個鼻嗰度啦，揾到個 eustachian tube 個 hole， 然後咧擠一條 catheter 上去。就去做一個 dilatation 咁樣嚇，咁你見得到咧個波咧並不是 all the way go up to the middle ear 嘅喎，因為咧個 eustachian tube 咧其實有兩部分嘅，一個部分係 soft cartilages， 另外一個部分咧係一個我哋叫 isthmus 嘅 bone， 一條好窄嘅骨，然後咧就走上去個 middle ear 嚇，咁嗰個位置咧其實咧根本上咧就唔係一個 catheter 可以走到上去嘅位置，而且你見到啦，佢畫嗰幅圖你都見到，就係話嗰個 isthmus exactly 就係、那個。carotid 嗰個位置嚇，咁所以變咗咧，撞嗰、那個嗰、那個 bony isthmus 係咪一個安全嘅嘢咧？咁個答案就唔係啦，咁樣樣，咁所以變咗咧，其實所謂我哋叫撞個 eustachian tuberoplasty 咧，就係、是、咧，只係咧，佢理論上咧就將你嗰個 mucosa 嘅 inflammatory 嘅 material 撞翻入去個 lymphatic system 同埋個血管入邊。去令到嗰個 information 嗰啲 cytokine 走翻入去嗰個 system 入邊咁樣樣啊，咁啊呢樣嘢咧，而家咧就係、是、一個我哋話都好流行啦。咁其實 Dennis Poe 去 做呢一個 triple plasty 咧都差唔多十幾年噶啦嚇咁樣樣。咁但係咧就初頭咧就第一冇一個 destiny 嘅 balloon system 啦。咁後來咧有咗啦咁樣樣，亦都係未係話全個地球都仲係好接受佢咁樣做啦咁樣樣。咁近呢幾年咧就真係越嚟越多centre 咧會去試呢一樣嘢。咁就話 emerging evidence 啦咁樣樣。咁啊都話佢有一個 at least 一個 temporary。Maybe long-term relief in 嗰個in the relief of the middle ear pressure 嘅 symptoms 啊咁樣樣，咁咧就亦都啱啱開始咧呢一兩年咧有少量嘅 pediatric paper 去 report 呢啲possible effectiveness in terms of 嗰個triple plasty 啦咁樣樣，咁但係佢都暫時仲係做緊兩歲後嗰啲嚇，大部分四至十一歲添咁樣樣，咁所以變咗咧而家喺 pediatric 咧仲係一個我哋叫做 off label 嘅 practice 啦咁樣樣嚇，咁同埋咧。點解你賺條 soft 嗰條個 part 會得嘅咧？但係你個 information 應該個 bony 個 part 都有嘅喎，嚇，而且應該係最窄嗰個 isthmus 都有嘅喎，咁樣樣，咁所以變咗會唔會其實有啲係賺咗唔得唔 report 咧咁樣？咁所以變咗咧呢一樣嘢，我哋都有啲 skeptical 嘅咁樣樣。咁但係香港而家都有咗呢個 balloon system 啦，咁咧就而家佢叫價就4000多蚊咯，咁樣樣。咁暫時就未有 pediatric case 做過。咁啊，據我所知咧 ，private 都有啲同事係有做嘅咁樣樣，但係主要都係 adult 嘅 case 啊，或者一啲好 marginal 嘅 pediatric 16歲啊嗰啲咁樣樣。咁我哋 keep an eye on this， 睇下點嚇。咁其實講完啦，咁咧就呢張係最後一張 slide。